out onto the field. Looks like the coaches have prepared something special for this home game against Carrollwood Day. Here come your Greenies. Dylan Lindsay and Jovan Hudson leading the way onto the field. Also down here is American Night in the student section. More and more Greenies are showing up for that. And yeah, the Carrollwood Day Patriots are coming from all the way from Tampa, Florida. I was talking with some of the football players before the game, and with, I think, 5 4-star recruits, this Patriots team is going to be a tough test tonight for the Greenies. They're coming in 0-1, losing to Madison County in Florida. However, they're hoping to have a bounce-back away game here at Faso Field. And for the Greenies, coming off a big 42-7 victory against Polk County last week. And before that, they took a loss in the home opener to Charlotte Latin. So hoping to give these Greenie fans something to cheer for tonight.
And our bright school captains for this evening is number 2, Zach Myers.
Turned off for a minute. Do you have notes or anything on them?
No.
All right. Could I do play-by-play for this game?
Sure.
We can obviously switch off, and obviously football is a combination of both guys, but
yeah.
All right. Are we going to wait for the anthem now? Or? All right, so for the anthem, I'm going to talk about the flyover and the aviation program. So. And I think Mr. Childers is going to come later with the tripod and do like a feature on us for CSBN.
Oh, nice.
So. Right now, as the national anthem is playing in the background, Mr. Thornberry and Stephen Hoffert, who's a parent of Christ School, just flew a plane over. And this is the first time in Christ School history there's actually an aviation sport for this winter. It's a new thing that Christ School has done for the year. And wanted to extend a big thank you to some of the donors that have helped with the plane, but Christ School actually bought a new plane for the school, and it's going to be a winter sport that's taking place, you know, throughout the winter. Students are going to get certified with basic flight requirements, you know, ground schools certified to fly with someone else and work on the 30-hour requirement to get their pilot's license. It sounds like a great program, Henry.
It really does sound like a good program. For those who were just tuning in, my name is Henry Stewart. Yeah, it's going to be an electrifying program here for the Greenies. Kids are calling it Top Greenie.
Top Gun Greenie.
Top Gun Greenie, yeah. And, we did a Top Gun style trailer for the reveal of the program at Assembly last week. But yeah, definitely exciting for sure. What else is exciting? This matchup right here. This is arguably one of the biggest matchups in Christ School history, taking on Carrollwood Day out of Tampa, Florida. Currently one of the best teams in Florida. Their running back and a name to keep an eye on is a guy named Anthony Carey, the sixth-ranked running back in the class of 2024. Very electrifying for sure, but this Christ School team poised and excited to come out for this victory here tonight. You know, as a manager with the team, I've been at practice. They've been working around the clock, 100%, 24/7, trying to get prepared for this game, and it's going to be a lot of fun to see what all those preparations do here tonight.
It is, and you know, I've been talking to some of the players as well, and they seem nervous for this game, you know, hoping to give the fans a higher scoring game than last time, you know, with no offensive touchdowns. And, you know, against Polk County, they found a lot of things that worked. They found spreading the ball out to the outside and relying a little bit more on the run game in early down situations was successful.
Very much so. This offensive line is one that has really stepped up here and gave Caden Brown really great running room last week. He ran for just over 100 yards and two touchdowns. Had a phenomenal ground game, also giving Trey Mooney the time that he needs in the pocket to make throws downfield. Throwing for three and running for one. Finished that night off with four total touchdowns. So the offensive line much improved and going to be a big factor here tonight. And everybody really excited here. It's a beautiful night for some football. A little cloudy, but overall pretty warm and still plenty of light, plenty of daylight outside as the two teams get set.
And, you know, Henry, it's going to be interesting to see how these offensive lines face off. Christ School, Tom Tang is going to be out tonight for Christ School. He sprained his ankle earlier this week.
And he did.
So they're going to be lacking a little bit on the offensive line where they've had some more strength in past games. But as we know, you win the game in the trenches. So
exactly.
When Christ School wants it, they're going to have to go get it at the line of scrimmage. This Carrollwood Day offensive line has been dominant in the games they played.
Absolutely. For Whom the Bell Tolls by Metallica playing, getting everybody riled up here, and we are underway here in Arden. Back to Khalil Conley, going to take it from just outside his end zone. Khalil Conley got a little bit of a crease. There goes Khalil Conley into the open field. Khalil Conley taken down right by the 50-yard line.
What a great run. He made three defenders miss there, a couple of jukes cutting it inside, and a little bit of trash talk there from Tavoy Fegan for the Patriots. It's going to be first and 10 for the Greenies.
Can definitely anticipate a lot of emotions out here tonight. Probably a lot of jaw-jacking between these two sides. Not going to distract us from a great game here tonight as out comes Trey Mooney and Caden Brown. Mooney set up in the shotgun. Caden Brown right next to him. Patriots showing a four-man rush. Mooney takes a snap. He fakes the handoff. Mooney to throw wide open. Cooper Perrone. First down for the Greenies.
Great job by Perrone finding the space in the middle of the field. Brought that ball past the 20. Huge first down play. And the Patriots are going to have to watch the middle of the field. They sent the blitzers there, as you were calling, and it did not pay off.
Absolutely not. Cooper Perrone, the guy that's usually playing a mix between outside linebacker and corner out there at receiver, makes a great grab on first down.
He was actually the starting running back for parts of last season. They like to move him all over the field, and you can see why on that play.
Very much so. Mooney sends Caden Brown out in motion. Khalil Conley motions into the backfield. Mooney takes a snap. He's going to step up, look to pump fake. Mooney on a scramble. Trey Mooney's got daylight, and he's got a touchdown. Touchdown, Greenies.
What a play by Mooney.
Christ School marches right down the field in two plays, and they have a 6-0 lead.
Mooney barreled through Noah Song as he found the goal line. He's a big runner at 6'3", I think 210 pounds. He's tough to bring down an open field, and you saw why there.
Very tough. We saw that last week against Polk County. Opening touchdown was a Trey Mooney scramble about 70 yards or so on a broken play. And out comes Matthew Hamill for the extra point.
Yeah, you got to give credit to the offensive line, though. They held up. They gave Mooney some time, and Hamill's going to sink this extra point.
No problem.
Into the backfield of Nolan there by the tennis courts, and the Greenies take an early 7-0 lead.
This is a fantastic start here for the Greenies. You know, running on with the team, these guys are hot, and they are showing it right here, just coming out firing on all cylinders. very different from the Charlotte Latin game. And their first offensive touchdown here at home, and they lead it 7-0 early here into the first quarter. Trey Moody getting some well-deserved congratulations by the coaching staff and teammates over on the sideline. And Matthew Hamble back out there to kick this one away for the Greenies.
We'll see how the Greenies do on this kickoff. They got some great blocking on the return there for Conley, and he did the rest, giving them a great start.
And
receiving the kick is going to be Almari Brown, a fast corner and receiver for the Patriots. Actually got three guys back there.
Interesting formation. Not a lot of, got some staggered blocking upfield. And as you pointed out, Henry, three guys back deep. Now, I've never seen this formation in a kickoff. Hamill sends a screaming line drive kick that's scooped up just past the goal line. And he's got an opening. Brown down the sideline. He may go. Can he get a block? Zach Myers trying to run him down. Can he get there? I don't know. Amari Brown is going to take it the distance. Touchdown, Patriots. Oh, my goodness.
No, they're going to call him just a yard short.
Oh, they are. It looked for sure like he got in, but
what a play by Myers preventing that. But, you know, I guess the three-man kickoff routine did work there.
I guess
great
so.
Blocking, and he just ran. Brown just ran right down the sideline. No one was there to touch him.
That was a terrific return really early into this one. This is going to be a barn burner here, folks. Electrifying play after electrifying play, and it's first and goal.
And, you know, one thing is to be said, there's a good bit of fans here from Carrollwood Day. Seems like some of them have traveled the distance, sitting on the greeny bleacher side, something you don't normally see. But, you know, those fans were very excited for that play as Brown had a chance to take it in. Here's the handoff.
And he's going to be taken down just shy of the goal line. Good defense there. Looks like Jack Scheimer in there for the tackle.
One ref signaled touchdown. The other signaled stop shy.
And they're going to call it. They are going to call it a touchdown.
Checking the score here on the Christ School versus Raven Gap away soccer game, the varsity game. It is currently tied up 1-1 at the start of the second half. The Greenies have had some history against Raven Gap in soccer, and the senior leaders were really, really excited about this one tonight. But so far it's tied up 1-1, just as this game right now.
And they're going to go for two. They're going to keep it out of the Wildcat. He's going to flip it short. That's a two-point conversion. And Carrollwood Day reclaims the lead on a two-point conversion.
Well, two short drives. You know, we're at 10:42 right now in the first. It's 7-7. This is the same amount of points that the Greenies scored the entirety of last game. So we're going to see. This seems like it's going to be a firepower offensive battle.
Very much so. And that's going to be a ton of fun to watch here.
Carrollwood Patriots 8 and your Greenies 7.
Well, this offense is going to have to get back on the field. You got to come back with some sort of answer to that. I'd say slow the pace down, honestly. The Patriots kickoff return to the 1, easy punch in. You got to grind some of these defensive guys out and slow the pace down a little bit.
Definitely. And the thing about this is the advantage of a short drive like the one you just came off of is it wasn't a sustained drive. It was a very short drive that only spanned two plays, which means that your offense is a lot more well-rested than they would normally be if they, you know, started out from the 25 or 30-yard line. You know, these guys are still fresh, so you have time to kind of wear down the defense a little bit.
You do, and here's the kickoff to the Greenies on the other side of the field now.
This is going to be taken. Oh, it's going to take a bounce and then scooped up by Zach Myers. It was a very weird bounce. It hit the ground and then just came right back down like it hit a puddle. And they're going to call him down right at about the 15-yard line. So the Greenies going to start a little bit backed up in their own territory here.
Now you got to go 85 yards. It's not 50 yards in two plays like you could do last time. It's going to be a little bit longer now, and here comes the Greenie offense. We'll see what this offensive line can do, and what Trey Mooney, the quarterback, can make happen here on first down.
Definitely a big playmaker. Can pull a rabbit out of the hat on just about any play. Mooney going to take the snap, and he's going to fake it. Mooney with a stiff arm. Trey Mooney not going to get much, but a heck of a stiff arm. Keeps him out of trouble. And they're going to call it a gain of about three. A broken play initially. Patriots in the backfield, but a great stiff arm from Trey Mooney to keep that play moving, and it's a positive gain.
Yeah, and the Patriots are going to have to respect the running of Trey Mooney. Two plays already out of the Greenies three, and Mooney's been with the ball. And although that was a broken play, he's a big guy. He's tough to bring down. They're going to have to contain him running if they want this defense to hold up now.
Absolutely. Mooney back in the same set. Shotgun. He's going to hand it off. Here goes Caden Brown trying to get around the edge, and he picks up a couple.
Great play there by Solomon Williams, breaking right through Dylan Lindsay and blowing up that play.
Dylan Lindsay is also not a guy to blow up very easily. He is massive, hands down one of the biggest players on this Christ School team, holds a number of different offers, including UMass, UConn, UNC Charlotte, and VMI.
Yeah, now Solomon Williams, on the other hand, 6'4", 230. This is probably the biggest defensive end the Greenies have seen this year. He's going to be a handful for Williams on the edge tonight.
Very much so. Mooney going to set up in the shotgun. Caden Brown to his right, third and five from the 18. Mooney with a snap. He's going to look to throw. Blitz coming from the Patriots. Can he get away? Makes a man miss and is ripped down. There's a flag. That's probably going to be a face mask.
Yep, that time again, it was Solomon Williams just absolutely bulldozing right through Caleb Cummings, who's there trying to block him. And what looks like a blown third down is probably going to be a new set for the Greenies here.
Yeah, just you got to play disciplined football, avoid the mistakes. And just, yeah. The Greenie student section chanting, "You can't do that." Taunting Solomon Williams a little bit. You know, as I said earlier, it's probably going to be a lot of kind of chippiness and jaw jacket between these two sides. A lot of energy coming in between these two sides. Trey Mooney sets up in the shotgun. Caden Brown again right next to him to his left. Three receivers to the right, one to the left. Khalil Conley there at the bottom of your screen. And he goes in motion. There's a handoff to Caden Brown. Puts his head down and picks up a nice couple of yards.
Yeah, it's looking right now on the field. Mooney's not going to have a lot of time in the pocket. So if you can establish something with the run game, it's going to force these linebackers to stay back and not blitz. So we'll see how the Greenies respond to this pressure because, you know, so far the Patriots are getting what they want on the line.
So far. But it's still early. It's second and seven. You know, a little chipping away, kind of, you know, 3-4 yards every carry. That's not bad at all. And just establishing that dominance, like you said. Here comes Mooney. Fires. What a catch by Zach Myers. Ripped out of his hands and incomplete. Almost intercepted.
Great play by Tavoy Fegan. He's one of those four stars that is ranked in the top 100 of 24/7 sports and a fast corner. You saw why there. He was beat by Zach Myers, an underthrown ball, and he makes the play to bring it up an incompletion.
That is a heck of a hit by Thegan, and it just jars the ball loose. That's a fantastic catch by Zach Myers. But Thegan just laying and putting his body right where it needs to go to force it an incompletion. Mooney going to set up in the shotgun. Three to the right, one to the left. Mooney under pressure. Good block from Caden Brown. Going to take a deep shot. Oh, Khalil Conley incomplete. Too tall.
Well, Mooney made a great throw on the run. They threw up a 50-50 ball and hit Conley. You know, it was anyone's ball there. And another great play by Fegan to get his hands up and bring up a fourth down for the Greenies.
Very much a ball hawk. Obviously, that's a tough catch to make, but you go up right there with the receiver to make a play on the ball like that. That's very impressive and a testament to his athleticism. And now Seth Schuler on the punt for the Greenies. He has been punting phenomenally in practice. Said he was ready to launch some rockets, talking to him pregame as you get set here. Two back deep to receive the punt. Another interesting kick return formation for the Patriots. Good snap, Schuler. This is a high, wobbly kick. Going to take a bounce out of bounds just past the 40, not quite at the 45. So it will start at about the 44-yard line or so.
Looks like it'll be spotted spot about the 37-yard line.
37, excuse me.
Well,
Patriots will start first and
10. A first and 10, this time not at the 1-yard line. We'll see what the Patriots look to. You know, the speed on the outside, it's going to be interesting to see which receivers they throw to. And also, with the departure of quarterback Colin Androff, who was a 4-star quarterback who transferred, it's going to be a new lineup in there. And I think that's number 13, Jake Cognulio, a quarterback here.
He's going to take the snap, rip it out in the flat, and it's complete. He's got space. Oh, nice move. Sends a defender flying. Oh, a little bit of extracurricular going on there after the tackle.
And that was a hard hit from Jacob Iwanek. He got low. C.J. Lewis on the reception, and he could not break through Iwanek. It's going to bring up second and about 4.
Yeah, good pickup there on first down. Really showing off some world-class speed right there. Double set for the Patriots. Good snap. They're going to hand it off up the middle. Good penetration. Jack Steimer and Caden Jones back there. Finally wrestling him out of bounds, but Jack Steimer came screaming into the backfield.
Yeah, the senior captain, he found a hole through the offensive line and drove the runner out of bounds, and Caden Jones was the last one to touch him. So it's 3rd and 2 now. I'd expect a run here from the Patriots.
Most likely. Also, just want to point out that is Anthony Carey on the handoff. Top 10 running back nationally. He's a junior, class of 2024.
He's going to be hard to bring down, an explosive guy, but we'll see how the Greenies handle it here.
Good snap. They're going to fake the handoff. Bootleg right side. Going to step up deep. Broken play. He takes the catch down the sideline. Trying to get run out of bounds, and he's in for the touchdown. Wow.
Isaiah Williams on the reception, another 4-star, and a great play on the edge. And it looked like Khalil Conley was fighting, covering 2 guys.
Just
a little zone coverage that was a little bit blown there, as you said, Henry. And now it's going to be another touchdown for the Patriots. And just great offensive firepower so far from them.
And now on for another 2-point conversion, playing very aggressive, and he's in no problem, and it's a 2-possession game now. It's 16-7.
Well, now you go back in the huddle if you're Christ School, figure out first how to stop the run. They did a great job there, but it's going to be about the guys on the edge. I was talking to Quentin Cancel earlier this week, senior corner, and he was saying some of these receivers are really tough to cover, especially there. Isaiah Williams, who caught that touchdown. It's going to be a battle out on the edges tonight.
Very much so. This is just going to be a very physical, very aggressive game. It's going to be going down all night. Very, very fun to see this playing out. Obviously not the result we're hoping for, you know, but the Greenies down 9 here about midway through the first quarter. But still plenty of time left. You go back to the drawing board, get right. You know, it's still early. And Zach Myers and Khalil Conley back deep to receive the kick.
Yeah, and you got to, like we were saying earlier, it's got to be a drive that isn't just one big play. Give your defense a little bit of rest. Give those guys some time. And yeah, we'll see. Greenies have had success this year returning kicks. Always find a way to get positive yardage. And with the two most explosive guys there, Khalil Conley and Zach Myers, something is always bound to happen.
Kicks away. It's a high boot taken in by Zach Myers. Zach Myers got a bit of a crease. He got tripped up, kept his feet. Myers finally dragged down just past the 35. Heck of a return, though. Nearly tripped up and dragged down a lot earlier, but just keeping his feet and pushing forward.
Yeah, he bumped around in there through a couple of defenders and found a way to get, I think, 15 yards after where he caught it. Here comes the Greenie offense.
Yeah, they really got to get something going here. Obviously not the result you hoped for on that last drive, but it's still early. You had a great drive to get yourselves in this ball game. It's 7-16. Still got a long ways to go, obviously. 6:39 to go in the first quarter. But definitely not too early to panic, but, you know, definitely start trying to get back in this one. Mooney in the shotgun. He's got a double set. He's going to take the handoff. He's going to hand it off to Caden Brown. Caden Brown with an opening.
Nice fight there. Looks like he got enough for the first down. A few yards after contact, lowers his head, low center of gravity. Patriots couldn't bring him down there.
His lower body is just so, he's just so well built, so powerful. He's just able to use that to bruise through defenders. Like you said, Henry, low center of gravity. Blowing through people. He's also really quick, really balanced power back. Khalil Conley out there one-on-one. Keep an eye on him, bottom of your screen. Mooney going to take the snap. He's got it. He's going to flip it. Oh, it's dropped, and then he's hit. And that's going to be incomplete. Overthrown by Mooney.
Yeah, a little bit of trash talk in there from Tavoy Fegan. That corner we were talking about earlier. And, you know, Conley didn't have a whole lot of room, and Fegan made a great play.
He really did. That was a throw that was too high for Conley. Mooney just threw it a bit too early and put too much on it. And we're going to come back out here second and 10. Shotgun look for Mooney. Caden Brown again right next to him. We see this set a lot. He's going to take the snap. He's going to hand it off to Brown. And tough Cohen there.
Brown was stuffed.
Yeah, great defensive pressure by the Patriots.
This defensive line is very physical. They're getting back there almost every play.
Yeah. This is a much improved Christ School offensive line. They played phenomenal last week. This is just a testament to how unbelievably good this defensive line is.
And not only are these guys big, but they're physical. And, you know, the speed off the ball is something that Christ School hasn't faced. And they're holding up on some plays, but consistently it's a lot of big guys up front. You got to protect the quarterback.
Yeah. Oh, pressure coming. Mooney going to flip it. There's Caden Brown trying to turn it upfield. Great flag, and it looks like there's going to be a flag down. That may be a late hit. The fans excited here. Trey Mooney picking himself up off the turf, and they are going to call roughing the passer on the Patriots. That is another drive extended by penalties on third down by the Patriots. Just careless mistakes.
It was Solomon Williams who got the pressure. Again, he knocked over Dylan Lindsay as he got in the backfield and hit Mooney after he threw the ball. So another penalty, an early penalty, you know, a couple of undisciplined plays from the Patriots defense is giving the Greenies chances to extend their drive.
Yeah, you cannot be committing penalties like that. But the Greenies, the best thing that you can do now is take advantage of the fresh set of downs in the 15 yards. And that's free yardage right there. You got to take advantage of that. And Trey Mooney going to come up here in the shotgun. Zach Myers trots out there to the bottom of your screen. One-on-one with Thiegen. And Mooney going to set up in the shotgun. Mooney going to fake the handoff. He's got a little bit of time, but we escaped the pass. Dumps it off Caden Brown. Into the second level, Caden Brown. Hurdles the defender. Lost the ball, but he was already down. But a heck of a job by Caden Brown to get this right at the 10-yard line.
Brown was a little shaken up by the hit from Fegan. It was a head-on play. Fegan stood his ground, and he went under. Caden Brown tried to go over. But it's going to bring up a first down for the Greenies, and Brown was not afraid of the contact that time.
No, very fearless, diving in there head first. The ball's going to be on the 12 of the Patriots, and another broken play results in a big gain for the Greenies. That's another time that we've seen that here tonight. And Mooney going to step up in the shotgun. He's going to take it off. There's Lou. He's going to power his way forward for only about a couple. And a Patriot.
Lou and Sia on the carry.
And there's Lou and Sia on the carry.
Yeah. Sorry, I got some room there. Broke through one defender, but only about 2 yards on that carry. It's going to probably... It's probably take a pass to the outside here for Mooney to get it, to punch it in for the Greenies.
Most likely, you just gotta. Yeah, let's see what they do. You got a lot of options right here. Lewithiel is still in the backfield. Got some good reps at the end of last week's game against Polk County. They're gonna try and rely on more. You know, Caden Brown, very much a workhorse, but you gotta spread it out too. They're gonna keep it. Mooney's gonna get swallowed up.
Yeah, 7 there. Great penetration from the Patriots, and now it's going to bring up 3rd and long.
Yeah,
in the red zone. The Greenies failed to punch it in home a couple of weekends ago here in Charlotte Latin, which ultimately, you know, cost them the game. But they had a lot better success against Polk County. They found plays that worked, and as this group grows together, they become more cohesive, and they know their styles, and the red zone just becomes easier and easier.
Exactly. You know, they were able to, like you said, they really just struggle against Latin. Can they punch it in here? Moody going to step up. He's going to fire. There's Cooper Perone. He's dropped it. He was looking upfield before he got his hands completely around the ball. And that's going to be incomplete. And out comes Matthew Hamill for the field goal.
If you kick the field goal here, you make it a one-possession game.
This is not a loss here. And I think Coach Chad Walker went back to the drawing board against Latin. You know, Christ School really did not go for any field goals against Charlotte Latin, and they're just going to take the points here, make this a one-possession game. So it's nice to see a little bit more conservative play calling here from Coach Walker, and making the right call and putting your trust in Matthew Hamill, who is, yeah, Hamill. Oh, it got blocked, but it still gets up through, and it's a one-possession game.
Great job from Hamill standing in there, making the play. That's Hamill's one of the outfielders on the varsity baseball team. He's not afraid to take one in there and take it from the baseballer, in this case, kick through 3 defenders.
Ice in his veins. That is Damian Lillard going for a game winner right there for my NBA fans out there. Ice in his veins, no fear, and he just drilled it. 16-10. Patriots still maintain a lead here late in the first quarter, but a solid drive from the Greenies slowly starting to get themselves back into this one.
Yeah, they were able to flip the field, get some points out of a drive. You know, it really came down to, I think, that roughing the passer from the three-star Solomon Williams. Yep, and that gave the Greenies a little bit of momentum, found a nice run from Caden Brown, and ended up with some points. We'll see what the defense can do here.
Yeah, they're going to be interesting to see as they've got, again, that triple set in the backfield down by the goal line to return the kick. Student section getting into it this evening. The theme for tonight is USA themed. Of course, we had the flyover, and really great to see the support. Oh, it's an onside kick, but it's recovered by the Patriots.
Well, Hamill put that ball where it needed to be, and just a great heads-up play that time from Christian Carter. That's going to give a very short field to the Patriots. You know, I don't hate the call, but now you got to pay. Now you got to pay for not recovering it.
Right. I think that definitely going aggressive is one thing, but also going for an onside kick, you know, kind of out of the gate here. I mean, that was your third possession of the night. And, you know, going right back at night again, like you said, now you have to pay the price and dig in and make plays. And the shotgun takes a snap. He's going to hand it off. There's Anthony Carey, and he's into the open field and tripped up. Good defense there by the Greenies to recover. And Anthony Carey showing the Christ School faithful the long extended arm, signaling, I just got a first down. And there's Jack Scheimer in there on the tackle, a guy that plays with absolutely no fear. He is in on every single play trying to make a tackle. Also a big Metallica fan, earned the nickname the CEO of Damage Incorporated, Damage Inc., or Damage Incorporated, the song off Metallica's 1986 album, Master of Puppets. It's one of his favorite songs and a nickname that he earned in the locker room. Shotgun look, he's going to hand it off, and there's Anthony Carey, stopped in the backfield. Jovan Broughton couldn't get him down. Anthony Carey, there's a flag down that might be holding.
I think they're going to call block in the back there.
Yeah, it looks like that was going to come back.
The speed of Anthony Carey on the edge, he is quick, and you know I understand why he's the top 10 running back in the nation. Not only is he speedy, but he finds holes and he makes big plays.
Very much so. It's speed that I've never seen before, you know. Obviously, Khalil Conley and Zach Myers, some crazy fast guys. And there is actually going to be a call holding on the Patriots, and that's going to bring them back. And again, the student section chanting, you can't do that, getting this crowd a good chuckle.
Well, yeah, some of the difference between some of these guys and Christ School's Beth athletes is huge. But remember, this is a team game, so one guy that's a fast receiver isn't going to be the one that's going to turn the tide of the game. The games like this are won at the line of scrimmage.
Exactly. This is a very complete unit. They are a brotherhood out here. Going to look to throw. Deep shot. Ashton got beating coverage. Oh, he stays on his feet, and there's Jack Scheimer on the tackle. Laying the boom in addition to Khalil Conley, and Noah Henthorne runs onto the field now.
Yeah, Parker, it was about a 10-yard out, and just a great reception there from Bredell Richardson on the right side of the field. I'll tell you what, he is big and physical out there. Richardson stands at 6'1", 170, which is significantly bigger than these Christ School corners.
Yeah, very much so. There goes running back into the open field. He may have a touchdown, cuts it back. That's a touchdown for the Patriots. Amari Brown, who almost had the kickoff return to start things out for the Patriots, finds pay dirt, and that's going to make it 22-10. Probably another two-point conversion coming and making this a two-touchdown game even.
Well, that's what I expect. I've had a lot of success with these two-point conversions, and the Greenie defense comes up short again. Just another great drive, and this time the drive was short. They didn't have to go as far, but it didn't matter here.
Two-point conversion, they're not going to get it. Or are they? Right down there by the goal line. No signal, and they are going to wave it. No good. The Greenies get a stand.
Big time. That'll hopefully give the fans a little bit of momentum here.
Hopefully
it's going to be a 12-point game now as the Patriots lead 22-10.
Your Christ School Greenies 10.
Plenty of time here. Not even out of the first quarter yet. 1:18 to go and an injury on the field. Helmet off, and he gets up and walking off under his own power. Always good to see.
Absolutely. The Greenies are going to be here to receive this kick. Like we said, offensive game. And right now it's been, can the Greenies get a stop on defense? They made a play there to get the two-point conversion, but something's going to have to change. It looks like the Patriots can get whatever they want running the football right now.
Yeah, you've got to step up. You got to say, you know, this is where our line in the sand is. And this is, you know, this is exactly what Coach Walker was talking about at practice all week and last week, you know. Be aggressive, you know, play as a team, you know, step up and make the plays. If, you know, if it's not your guy but you're there, make that play. Very much, you know, a brotherhood mentality to be there for each other and, you know, play physical, play aggressive. Obviously very cliche things, but things that are really overlooked and, you know, they are still very much important. There's a reason people say them a lot. And the Greenies have shown a lot of toughness this year. You know, it's been a rough start so far, but they're hanging tough. It's only a two-possession game. You still got plenty. You got a whole other three quarters to go. Students and the fans getting riled up. Welcome to the jungle by Guns N' Roses. Playing and getting this crowd on their feet. We are back underway. High kind of squib kick taken really high up.
Jacob Iwanek grabs the ball, and he's going to be shoved out of bounds at about the 33.
Interesting guy. He's a, you know, he's a linebacker, defensive end. He's not a guy that's the fastest. He's, you know, they don't have him back there with Khalil Conley and Zach Myers taking kicks. That's just a short kick that he was just able to pick up and take off with.
Well, yeah, Iwanek, he played running back on the JV team a few years ago, and you know he's a guy that has some explosiveness, and that's why they put him at linebacker where he can make plays. But good job to wrap up there and bring the ball past the 30 for the start of the Christ School drive.
And out comes Trey Mooney, Lou Ethel next to him. And the shotgun, Mooney. They run this possession. They run this formation on pretty much every play. They're going to take the snap, and Mooney has some time. Open! There is Matthew Pethel. That's going to be a first down.
Yeah, it was actually Brewer-Nitcher.
Excuse me.
He's a sophomore.
But he is massive. He is one of the tallest guys on the team. He's only a sophomore.
Yeah, he's listed here at 6'4", 180.
Just
definitely, you know, he made a great break off the ball and had an open slant for a first down for Christ School.
Great catch, and again, 6'4", as a sophomore. I am a junior. I'm currently standing at about 6'2". Just put that in perspective. Mooney under some pressure. Kim Mooney's going to get tripped up and taken down.
Yeah, it looked like he tried to throw that away, but the pocket was collapsing.
Just
going to take a sack there. Yeah, it looked like Will Newman got hit at the end of the play by Tavoy Fegan. Who's been all over the offensive and defensive side of the field.
Yes, he has, and playing really, really aggressive and furious here tonight. But this is going to take us to the end of the first quarter. About 7 seconds left, but both teams kind of in the huddles. Plenty of time on the play clock. Just going to let this run down. And there we go. There's the end of the first quarter. Your score after one at Christ School 22. And the Patriots 22, Christ School 10.
Yeah, a little score update from the varsity soccer game over at Raven Gap. Currently, it's tied up with 13 minutes left to go in the second period. That one's going to come down to a nail biter. And I think you can – there's a live broadcast out there from Raven Gap if you want to tune into that. But we're going to about to start the second quarter. It's going to be Greenie ball. We'll see what they do. Second and long here in a moment. Welcome back to Christ School Broadcast Network now. Currently 22-10 lead for the Carrollwood Day Patriots from Tampa, Florida against the Christ School Greenies here in Arden.
First and 10 for the Greenies. They're going to hand it off. There's Lou Ethel. That's going to be the first down. Lou Ethel making the most of the reps he's getting.
Here starts a third and short. Sorry. It's still going to be third and long because Mooney took a sack back there. See what the Greenies go to.
Right. Mooney going to look to throw pressure. Comet flips it. Too low for Zach Myers and incomplete.
And it's a flag over on the side of the field.
Let's see. Let's check that out.
They could potentially call holding on the defense. It was very physical, again, from Tavoy Fegan over against Khalil Conley on the right side of the field.
And a bit of confusion. There's some deliberation going on between the officials. There was a flag down. What's going on?
No flag on the play.
Oh, and they pick up the flag. So, yeah, it's going to be 4th and 9.
I think there was no flag. The flag may have fallen out of the referee's pocket on the far sideline, but here's Seth Schuler to punt the football off. Greenie defense.
Got to make a play
huddling up down on the field. They're going to have to make a play, as he said.
Seth Schuler on a punt. Snaps up. Schuler. Oh, it nearly got blocked.
It did get blocked.
Yeah, I think he did get a piece of that, and it spirals out of bounds on the right sideline. They're going to take over from the 44 of the Patriots.
This is our first.
Well, Greedy defense. They're called on to make plays in the past. This will be the longest drive that the Patriots have had to make, even starting at the 40. That punt wasn't quite able to flip the field thanks to a great defensive stop from the Patriots, and now you're tasking your defense to make big plays.
Right. And we got trips to the bottom of your screen. One man up top, bit of flinching. Who moved first? That's the question.
Yeah, Noah Henthorne. I think he jumped there.
And they are going to call offsides on Noah Henthorne, getting some reassurance from his teammates. He's going to move the ball first and five up to the 49. Just a yard shy of midfield.
Well, it looks like a similar play.
Yeah, trips left. One up top at the top of your screen. Oh, he somehow avoided the sack. Helmet comes off. Can they get him down? Oh, Caden Jones lowers the hit stick.
Yeah, he wrapped him up there, but still almost a first down. A gain of about four, and that's just a great play from the quarterback.
Brings up second down and one to go.
Yeah, Jake Cudniglio, the quarterback. Not a whole lot of experience, but he's playing well tonight.
So far, so good, exactly. Snap from the Patriots. They're going to hand it off. Good penetration in the backfield. But he's going to turn the corner, and there's Anthony Carey again. It's going to be off more than enough for a first down, about 10 yards on the carry.
Taken down by Caden Jones.
Caden Jones on the tackle again. Luke Anderson comes off the field. They've got a lot of guys playing both sides of the football here tonight. Luke Anderson usually playing and rotating around between different guard positions. They've got him down there on the defensive line. They've got Noah Henthorne on the defensive line, also playing on the offensive line. This is a team that has taken some injuries and have had to have some guys step up big time. So definitely some adjustments, you know, still trying to figure things out, which isn't helping the Greenies. Snap by Kalinknia, going to take a deep shot.
Well, there's
a chance. There's a flag down. He makes the catch. Let's see what the flag is.
Yeah, the play is going to be called back.
I think so.
For a touchdown, but a flag on the play.
This may be holding. It seems to be the common theme tonight. Let's see what the official call is. Talking to the head coach of the Patriots. An eligible receiver downfield. That's going to wipe off the touchdown.
Yeah, they didn't have enough guys. They had one of the guys that was set up on the offensive line that ran her out there, and it's going to bring the play back. You know, that was a beautiful throw downfield on Quentin Cancel. He was tight on carry, but
that's just a heck of a throw. That is putting the ball quite literally right where it needs to be. There's sometimes where you can just play the best coverage in the world and the quarterback or the receiver just makes a simply better play. There's really not a whole lot you can do in that situation. It's going to bring the play back first and 15. Going to hand it off. There's Amari Brown. Caden Jones.
What a
ring in the boom. And a rip it down Amari Brown.
Well, I'll tell you what. Caden Jones certainly earns the title as one of the Greenies' best defenders. He's a four-star, making a few more official visits to USC and some schools in the Midwest. But, you know, that was just a great tackle against a speedy and athletic running back.
Very much so. And Caden Jones, for our viewers at home, as you were saying, he is a four-star recruit. He's also the 11th-ranked linebacker in the class of 2024, an Under Armour All-American and ESPN Top 150 recruit.
I think he's top 100 now.
I believe he is. Also the second-ranked player in the state behind Jaden Daniels. That's going to be a nice, knocked out of bounds. And that'll be a knock.
Pass complete to Lewis.
Well, to Anthony, the Patriots, this is going to be four down territory. Although it's third and long, you're in the greeny side of the field, and you know that their offense has struggled the last couple of possessions. So you got two plays now to get 7 yards. So we'll see what they go to here. I'd expect a run in there to Amari Brown.
Most likely.
Who they've ran with recently.
On third downs, right. Shotgun look for Kalignia. He's some jumps, and that may be off. Fingers pointing both ways. I saw movement from both sides. I don't know. And it is going to be offsides again.
Offside goes against the Greenies.
Yeah, a couple of jumps from this defense. Now it's third and two.
Right, that's a third and long versus a third and short, you know, in plus territory. You know, this is right on the edge of field goal range for the Patriots, but given their style of play, I don't even know if they would attempt a field goal. Snap by Caligny is going to roll out of the pocket. They've run this before. Oh, what a catch by Isaiah Williams. Tightropes it and is knocked out of bounds.
Yeah, C.J. Lewis on the grab. What a play. just a little bit overthrown by Coniglio, and just like we said, a great acrobatic catch and a first down for the Patriots.
This team is just full of talent and athleticism, and this is, again, not a testament to how the Greenies are. This is a very talented Greenies team. It's just a testament to how good this Carrollwood Day team is, and the Greenies have hung 10 points on them, and they've got some really potent defenders. It's impressive. And the shotgun, Caligna going to hand it off. Carey got an opening. Anthony Carey taken down just shy of the 10-yard line. Nice carry on the ground.
Carey had the ball, and Caden Jones on the tackle.
Caden Jones, another tackle for him, having himself a great game tonight.
Yeah, that was a great block by the left tackle there. Completely sealed off Ethan Serrano, and just no Greeny defenders in sight.
Yeah,
after a good block up front.
Yeah, Ethan Serrano, the very talented freshman out of Dallas, Texas. Gonna hand it off. Carey gonna be taken down. Good defense there. Carey not getting much.
Anthony Carey with the ball.
Maybe 2 yards on that carry.
That's going to bring up second down.
And he makes it to the 5-yard line where it's second down and goal to go.
Yeah, second and goal from the about the 5-yard line or so. Just under 8 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Patriots get the ball coming out of the half. So this is a big possession here. I formation for Caligna. Going to hand it off. Carey got hit. He didn't get it. He's just a couple yards shy. There's Jack Scheimer.
Yeah, Jack Scheimer is voted the head prefect by the student body. He's a prefect and gardener. And, you know, he's new last year at school, made his impact on the football field early, and has also found success socially. He's a great guy. I love being around Jack Scheimer.
As do I, a guy that is in my advisory. And that's going to be a handoff. That's a touchdown.
No, they're short.
They're short. I was looking at the wrong player. My apologies. He lost his hat. Puts it down, and Jacob Iwanek on the tackle. Still nursing a nasty bruise on his left arm. But again, no fear. And the defense comes off the field.
Timeout.
And the Greenies going to burn their first timeout.
Well, yeah, the Patriots are going for it here. This could be an absolutely pivotal stop for this defense.
This is on the verge of this is either you make a play here and you get some momentum back, or you let them score and it's kind of backbreaking.
Well, yeah, going down 3 scores in the second quarter, even if you put something up, it's going to be a tough battle to get back into this one. And right now, this defense has a chance to really swing the momentum.
They do. And to get them hyped up, House of Pain's Jump Around. The student section doing just what the song tells you to do. They're jumping around and having a good time. Seniors, again, doing a fantastic job rallying the students and getting them loud and on their feet. Really talented and, really passionate group of guys. I guess you could say they're very talented at getting guys hyped up. Waving a big old U.S. flag down there as we celebrate our beautiful country here tonight. And a special thank you to all service members and veterans on the stream. We thank you so much for your service.
Absolutely. I think it's tomorrow or next weekend's game is going to be the Veterans Memorial game for the Greenies, but the flyover tonight, we're so appreciative.
Really special. Oh, a flag down.
It's going to be another offsides on the Greenies. The mojo is off on this defensive line.
And it is going to be offsides again. Man,
that's 3 offsides.
2 on this drive alone. They are just, like you said, Henry, they just seem to be kind of out of rhythm tonight, at least defensively. It's kind of a polar opposite from against Charlotte Latin.
Carey's going to be in.
And that's another touchdown. That is his second of the evening. It's going to make it 28-10 with 6:51 to go in the second quarter.
Well, the defense couldn't come up with a stop.
Again, the penalties.
Now it's going to be a 3-score ball game.
Right. And again, Henry, we were talking about, for Carrollwood Day, the penalties, the lack of discipline, extending drives to the Greenies. Same thing is happening now to the Greenies, and it's benefiting the Patriots, Carrollwood Day. You got to get it cleaned up. You got to get it together. You got time. Get in the locker room and just get set, get right. And they do actually kick the extra point, and it's good. It was nearly blocked. but it's still good. And it's a 19-point game.
Carrollwood City Patriots 29, Greenie School 10.
We've got some Metallica playing down here, and Jack Scheimer shredding the air guitar down on the field. That is just the kind of thing to get him going. Type of thing to get me going. If you don't get a rush out of getting some good Metallica, you might want to check for a pulse.
Well, it's going to be the kickoff now for John Garrettin.
And back deep again, Khalil Conley and Zach Myers. Pick your poison on the return here. Squib kick. Oh, there's a flag down. This may be moving back a couple of yards.
And that goes against the Patriots.
And it is going to be against the Patriots. And again, though, you can't do that chant from the students. Third time we've heard it. One of the couple of times we've heard that tonight. Never fails to get a good laugh out of the fans here. It's going to be an illegal procedure. It's going to back him up 5 yards.
Well, that's going to move the kickoff back a few yards, as you said. And I just got an update. The Cray School versus Raven Gap soccer game has now gone to overtime, tied 1-1. 10 minutes left to play in overtime, and we'll let you know when we hear more.
Absolutely. Heck of a game. That is going to be a kick out of bounds. That's going to be a flag. Oh, and Jack Scheimer getting into it with a Patriot.
Yeah, that was Noah's Song that initiated the contact. Scheimer not putting up with it.
Not
no flag. The referee's letting the players talk a little bit and make a little contact, but it's going to be Greenie ball. Good field position to start this drive.
Very good field position to start the drive. Also, just that, you know, kind of that contact going out down there. Jack Scheimer's not a guy that's going to go down there and instigate. You know, this is just, you know, this is a very aggressive Carrollwood Day team.
The Greenies will start first and 10 on our own 40-yard line.
And the Greenies going to start at their own 40-yard line. 6:51 to go here in the second quarter, 29-10. Carrollwood Day on top. And Trey Mooney going to step up. He's going to hand it off to Athiel, trying to bounce off tackles, and he's probably going to get tackled for a loss. Tough sledding there.
Well, it looked like he got just – that was Lou there that just got just back to the line of scrimmage.
Second down and 10.
Second and 10.
Yeah, they're going to call no gain on the play. Trying to get the crowd kind of into it. Energy's fading a little bit here. As Mooney sets up in the shotgun, fakes the handoff under pressure. Can he get rid of it? Mooney somehow stays in bounds and picks up a couple of yards on that carry.
He may have even picked up 5 yards. It depends on the spot.
You're watching him play, you think, oh man, he's going to get sacked. No, he's not. He's going to turn that into a solid chunk play. He's going to bring up 3rd and 6. He's just so unbelievably talented at getting outside the pocket and turning quite literally nothing into something. A magician that is so much fun to watch.
He's very athletic in and outside of the pocket. He's still looking to the receivers, though, to make a big play and get them back in this one.
Absolutely. 3rd and 6. Mooney dropped back, going to flip it short. There's Khalil Conley. Stiff arm. Stays in bounds as a tightrope back. Khalil Conley.
with a nice catch and run for a Greenie first down. That's going to get this crowd back into it.
A great catch, a great run after the catch. He got past the 35. Big play and, you know, just a great spin move on a talented corner there. Was able to give the Greenies a big first down with 5:45 left here in the second.
Just huge, and it's really just Khalil Conley was such a major addition to this class. He also reclassified as a junior, so the Greenies still have him for another year, and that's another year for him to get even better. He really can't do it all for this team. Mooney gonna get out of the pocket, put it on the deck, puts it back up. Trey Mooney, oh, gets blasted. But
well,
gets up.
That was a strip play by Amari Brown, the running back who got back there, got his hands on the ball, and Mooney fumbled it. He picked up the ball, though. So it's going to be second and 14. Second and long, you know, for the Greenies. But a great recovery for Mooney, because it would have been the Patriots' ball. And they've been on a roll scoring right now.
They have been. And that's, again, that's just Trey Mooney's ability. You know, even though it's a four-yard loss, that was probably going to be about close to 10, 12-yard loss originally. The fact that he was able to turn it upfield a little bit and pick up some yardage. And the student, oh, there goes Mooney, flips it short. Lou Asilio into the secondary. Asilio bouncing forward. First down, Greenies.
And Lou's one of the most high-energy guys on this Christ School team. He is a friend to all, and he gets everyone fired up. Coming in and playing some big running back minutes with Caden Brown, who was a little shaken up here in the first. A great catch after the – or great run after the catch there. Another first down, and this is going to be inside the 20-yard line
in the red zone again. Can they cap it off with a touchdown now? No, but great – absolutely true what you were saying about Lou. You know, a friend to all, like you said, and, you know, always cracking jokes and always being, you know, very outgoing and friendly to everybody. A guy that, you know, is in my U.S. history class, constantly cracking jokes and messing around with Mr. Chester and E-Block honors U.S. history. Just a great guy, really laid back and really high energy. Made a great play there and a timeout called as the two teams going to head over onto the sidelines.
Well, yeah, Henry, the Patriots, seems like they can get whatever they want on offense right now. Especially with the run game, they're getting some big holes up front.
Really, I mean, they have this offensive line. I was saying it earlier; they're improved, but they also got banged up. But they are doing a fantastic job tonight, giving the Greenies that safety valve in the run game, creating the space necessary. Obviously, Caden Brown a little bit shaken up, but Luisia has come in and done a fantastic job picking up the slack. Finally, starting to get some more looks and. And also just a friendly reminder for all things Greenie Sports, check out the Greenies Instagram page at Greenie Sports on Instagram and Twitter, as well as Facebook, to get live updates on all things Greenie Athletics. And definitely keep up with that soccer game, which is still 1-1 in overtime, going down, I mean, just a barn burner against a very good Raven Gap team.
It seems close over there, and now for the Greenies, they have a chance to bring this within a two-score game now on the football field inside the red zone.
Yeah, this is a big possession here. Mooney going to step out of trouble, and he's going to stiff arm. Oh, thrown! That's going to be a flag. Thrown into the construction area. The student center, which is being renovated right on the top of your screen, gets thrown into the tape surrounding the building. They're doing construction over there. Getting thrown into there, and that's
unnecessary
roughness call.
We're seeing a little bit too much energy right now on the defensive side for both teams. The Greenies, three or four offside penalties, and that's I think three unsportsmanlike conducts on the Patriots players, roughing the passer or hit out of bounds. So
right,
they got to shore things up. You know, they've got a lead, but. You can't get careless on defense. Those kind of plays are the ones that the Greenies didn't earn. And now it's going to be a first down at the 11-yard line.
On the 11-yard line now, big-time penalty for the Greenies. And a nice scramble already by Trey Mooney. But I think it's you kind of have – there's a bullet. There is Zach Myers. Myers right on the goal line. Touchdown, Greenies. Zach Myers making plays on both sides of the ball. and the Greenies are back in it.
They ran a little like bubble screen to him. He came back inside, and just a great catch and run. Myers actually had a little promo interview with head of school Dr. Jenkins earlier this week, and they were talking about the game, what they were looking forward to, and Myers seemed excited for the game, telling Dr. Jenkins that he was going to make some big plays tonight, and he sure has, Henry.
Absolutely. Again, Zach Myers, arguably the greatest football player in Christ School history, ranked as a four-star athlete, the 22nd ranked athlete in the nation, currently committed to play at NC State. Talking to him about that, said that he just loves it. Oh, it's a fake! Picking it off the deck and taking down shy. The Greenies go aggressive and the extra point.
It wasn't a fake there. Hamill's kick got blocked. It landed in the hands of Jacob Iwanek, and he just kind of grabbed it and tried to run with it.
Yeah,
that's another great special teams play from the Patriots. They're making plays right now in special teams.
Absolutely. My apologies. It just kind of happened so fast.
It's still only a 13-point game. However, defense has got a chance to stop and give the offense one more possession to make something happen here.
Indeed. You got to come back out. You got to play with that energy. You got a lot of guys out there that are very talented and can make some great plays. Just got to see them step up and make those plays. This is hands down one of the biggest games in the history of Christ School. A big-time team like this coming up the mountain all the way from Tampa, Florida. That's about a 6 or 7 hour drive.
No, Henry, it's a lot more than that. I think it was 3 hours flying the last time I came up here. I think it's over 10 hours to get up here.
Oh, wow.
They made a serious trek, and right now they're showing why they're from Florida. This is a great football team, but Greenie's staying in it right now. Two-possession game. The defense yet to make a stop, but one stop can really turn this around. The offense is starting to click here tonight.
Yes, they are. Trey Mooney getting that confidence. Lewisia getting some nice carries on the ground, getting heated up. Lou Hamill, Matthew Hamill want to kick this one away. Maybe a little bit of frustration after that block. They're going to go pooch it. Oh, it's over the head of a Patriot and then scooped up.
Well, that looked like a very successful pooch kick for Hamill. The ball's going to be placed at about the 32-yard line, the longest drive yet for the Patriots.
Let's see if the Greenie defense can benefit off the long field for the Patriots.
Yeah, and the receivers for Carrollwood Day, they've had serious success tonight. See if Quentin Canzel, Ashton Parker, the bookend corners to the Greenies, can prevent some big plays here.
Stuck to look for Coligna. He's going to throw it. There's Carey. He's got space over by the sideline. There's Cade and Jones laying the hit stick. Cade and Jones making sure that Carey and the other Patriots in the area are okay after that hit. Some true sportsmanship right there from Cade and Jones.
Yeah, but it's going to be second and short. Quentin Canstell tried to keep Carey out of the play, but just that was a great block from Isaiah Williams on the bottom of the screen.
He's been making plays seemingly all right. Leading up, going to hand it off to Carey. He's going to get taken down. Jack Scheimer in the backfield initially and was able to slow him down, but the reinforcements got there.
I think it's going to maybe a... It's not a loss of a yard, but it is third and inches. This defense has got a chance.
That's a solid stop. It is very close to a third down. And they're going to call it good enough for a first. One official saying it's short, one saying it's enough, and they're going to move the chains and say that that's a first down.
Well, the Greenies, not huge yardage there. Defense still got to contain the run.
It is going to be third and one. Kalinga going to take the snap. Deep shot, open man. Too high, knocked, incomplete. Khalil Conley out there in coverage, laying the hit, knocking the receiver away from the ball, making sure he doesn't get a chance to get it and wave it incomplete. That is going to be a stop for the Greenies.
Well, C.J. Lewis was the intended receiver there. That stop's going to bring up second and long, but Khalil Conley, even if Lewis had got his hands on that, I'm not sure he would have held on. Conley was right there to lay the hit.
Laid a big-time hit out there.
Well, second and long, like we said, and they've had success throwing long. One safety back for the Greenies and five receivers right now.
Snap taken, Kaligna, pressure coming. Barely got rid of it, Jordan Edgecombe. Ball is on the turf. The Greenies are on top of it. The Greenies get the takeaway, and it is the Greenies ball.
What a play. An incredible strip. That was Jordan Edgecombe, as you said, the 10th grader, making a big-time play at the defensive line.
Oh, man, he plays a position of edge rusher, of defensive end, and the outside linebacker, the sophomore, talking to him on the bus ride home from Polk County, talking about how he just wanted to get some offers and get some recognition. Well, Jordan Edgecombe, you just got yourself a strip sack and put the Greenies back in this one. I'd say you got some recognition.
And yeah, Josh Harrison did a great job diving on that ball between two Patriots. Give some credit to him, the 6'3 edge rusher, making a play as well to give this offense another chance, starting the drive at the 30.
In plus territory, big time turnover. Mooney gonna throw it, flip it out. There is Zach Myers, who takes a big hit, but hangs on and catches it. Loads, gonna bring up second down and about four.
Gain of four on the play, brings up second down and six.
Second and six coming up here for the Greenies.
Well,
Zach Myers
first,
on that receiver.
You know, I think the Greenies have yet to have a few drives that don't have a sack in them yet. So getting even a little bit of positive yardage on first down can make a big difference on a drive with a short field.
Absolutely. Every yard counts. Mooney under pressure. Escapes the sack. Flings it downfield. Oh, it's broken up and incomplete, looking for Khalil Connolly up top. Broke out of a sack and flung it downfield. He just put it a bit too high on the 50-50 ball. Khalil Connolly trying to go up and get that. Got hit as he tried to catch it, and it's incomplete. It's going to bring up third and six from the 27. You're still in field goal. You're really on the edge, kind of fringe field goal range.
I think it's fourth down territory right now. Coach Walker likes to go for it. It's going to be a long field goal, and the special teams has not done a great job blocking tonight. I think this is fourth down territory, 1 minute and 40 seconds, and even if you give the ball back to the Patriots, they don't have long to go. So
that's a very good
point. Do
what
you can here.
Let's hope it doesn't even come to that. Trey Mooney in the shotgun. Luithia in next to him in the shotgun. Mooney, good snap. He's got pressure. Going to fling it short. There is Hessel. He's got it into the second level. Spinning free of defenders. That is more than enough for a first down. That's going to be a first and goal.
And that is a first
big first down for Lou Isaiah. And just a good job breaking through tacklers. A couple of crucial first downs for Lou. And it stops the clock momentarily. You don't have to quite worry about the clock yet at a minute and 32 at the moment. But, you know, if you can wind down a little bit more and prevent the Patriots from having a lot of time, that certainly helps your defense.
Absolutely. A touchdown would be monumentous right here. Empty backfield for Mooney. Two to the top of your screen, three to the bottom. Mooney under immediate pressure, flings it in the air. Oh, my goodness, what a catch. Incomplete, but there's a flag down. How in the world did Zach Myers come down with that?
Well, the throw was a little bit out of bounds, and Myers was pushed out, I think, by Tavoy Fegan. He didn't turn his head around, and that's going to be pass interference. Not only that, Fegan, he's been taunting a little bit there, too. Help the finger, no there, but it's getting a little chippy out here.
It really is.
I'll tell you what, in this pass interference, it's going to move the ball within the 5-yard line, I believe, so first and are not even very short right now. It's going to be, I think, placed at the 7-yard line, 7 yards to go. And
a fresh set of downs.
I believe the Patriots are calling a timeout here. Greenies come to the huddle. You drop a play. Henry, what are you looking to here?
What I'm going to do right here is I'm going to keep my options open. I am going to honestly put my faith in Trey Mooney. He is so deadly in these goal line situations. Like you were saying, he is a massive guy. And he is unbelievably talented as a runner. So I think that you run a little bit of an RPO here. You get Luisia in the backfield. You have Zach Myers, maybe Will Newman or Khalil Connolly coming on a slant route. And you give the ball to Trent Mooney and let him make the decision, because he really is a leader on and off the field, in the locker room, always getting the guys hyped up, making sure everybody's good to go. And I think that you give the ball to him in this situation with his frame, very much a Cam Newton style of runner, just faster.
Yeah,
I give it to Trey Mooney.
Friday night is a
I'd say you got to have a running back in the backfield to keep the defensive linemen from getting in there. When they ran five wide this last play, it was like there were five blitzers on Trey Mooney. He just had to heave the ball up to Myers. So if you're throwing it here, I think you got to have a blocker. But I wouldn't be surprised if they ran some sort of inside zone there to Lou, number 24.
Yeah, they're going to hand it off. It is bootleg for Mooney. Going to fire. Caught. Cooper Perrone going to be taken down just shy of the goal line.
I think he's at the three. And not only that, ball's inbounds. Clock should keep rolling. I don't know why they paused
yet. Yeah, it's paused. There's nobody. Clock is not running for some reason. Stopped at 1:02 to go here. Patriot comes running off. Maybe a bit of maybe it's just some confusion going on between the officials. I think so. They're trying to talk.
Well, yeah, the chain gang has first down up on the pylon.
And now they're going to wave off a timeout. Yes. Who called it?
Yeah, Patriots called it.
And the Patriots
clock started running there right at the end of the play. I think the Greenies actually picked up a first down there. They were not quite inside the red zone yet. So that's why the clock only paused, and the Patriots don't want any more time to tick off. They want another offensive chance.
I think so.
But I think they've got one timeout left after this. So, yeah, the Greenies have a real chance to make this a one-possession game after what seemed like an almost insurmountable deficit here in the second.
Yeah, they have battled back and fought hard. And the pregame speech from Coach Walker compared these guys to the Spartans in their last stand at Thermopylae, going against all odds and fighting as true, fierce, honor-bound, loyal warriors. And they're showing that warrior spirit out here tonight. Ball at the three. 58 seconds to go in the first half. 29-16. You score here, you get the PAT. It makes it 23-29. It's a one-possession game. And a heavy stack set. Wildcat. Caden Jones going to take the direct snap. He's got a touchdown.
Well, they love running read option to Caden Jones. Punches through the defenders. And number 7 found the end zone there for the Greenies score. And now it is a one-possession game, barring the success on this extra point for Matthew Hamill. But I love the play call there. You get three blockers in front of Caden Jones on the left side, moving towards those defenders, and they punched it in there, Henry.
Absolutely. A lot of misdirection, a lot of jet sweeps. They've actually got a couple of plays. I won't reveal that, but no, they've got a lot of trick plays, a lot of fun to watch. Matthew Hamill, good on the PAT. And it is a 6-point ball game.
And
Christ School right back in this one.
Yeah, Hamill got decked at the end of the play there. It's going to be, I think, a roughing the kicker, which should be enforced on the kickoff.
Yeah, there is a flag down thrown late.
Yeah, I believe so. The Patriots have been chippy tonight after the play. Multiple unsportsmanlike conducts, as we said. And now the Greenies, the defense has got to make a stand with 52 seconds in the second.
Absolutely. Great job by Matthew Hamill, but this is just a team that has really just fought hard tonight. That turnover really swung the momentum back in favor of the Greenies. The crowd really getting into it. Excuse me. Uptown Funk by Bruno Mars playing. Got everybody dancing, even myself dancing a little bit. As it's only a 6-point game, 52 seconds to go in the second half. In the second quarter. As we get set here.
Well, some of the Greenie fans running to the concessions. I'm not sure what that's about. There could still be some big plays left in the second year.
I know. Everybody always complains about being, there was a kickoff and we didn't see it. You know, you're leaving early. That's why. Stuff can still happen. Stick around, folks. We still got a heck of a game in front of us.
Well, I just got confirmation that the first overtime period ended scoreless, so we're going to double overtime there, Raven Gap, for the soccer game.
Wow.
It's currently still tied 1-1. A couple of goal kick opportunities. Greenie's unable to convert. Second overtime, and after this, it'll go to penalty kicks if neither team can score. So we'll keep you in the loop there.
Yeah, heck of a game. Huge effort, and great job by our varsity guys. A lot of great guys on that team. and a heck of an effort by them against a very tough Raven Gap team, is no less.
Well, Matthew Hamill here to kick it off again. It's going to be from the opposing 45 because of that 15-yard penalty.
Right.
We should be able to kick this one back to the end zone or maybe to the corner and not allow a big return.
Right. Because there is, again, Matthew Hamill, he was just straight up hit staked. That's a 15-yard penalty, which is roughing as opposed to running into the kicker, which is only five. Hamill drills this one. That's going to be a touchback. Way back there. Oh, he was about to hit the kicker. He was about to try and return this one, but he steps out of bounds.
He does. Almost advantageous there. There are a lot of greenies nearby.
Would have been a big-time stick. Maybe you get a chance for it up. Maybe you get a safety or hit him and the ball comes loose. You never know. Down by the goal line like that. But he gets steps out, so the ball is going to come out to the 25. Longest drive of the night for the Patriots.
Yeah, it's got to handle it. It's going to be up to the greenie defense. You got to keep the runner in bounds so the clock ticks. You can allow big plays. Just keep him slightly out of field goal range, and you go into halftime feeling good about your situation.
Absolutely. The Greenies have made some great progress here.
It's a blown play.
It's a flag down.
Too many men on the field for Christ School.
I think so. Oh, big hit. Oh, another big hit. A lot of the Greenies coming up and laying a little bit. Yeah, flag down coming in pretty easy. Let's see what the call is. I believe it is too many. This may be a holding call.
No, it was Jacob Iwanek was running off the field. Christ School had too many men, so a free play for the Patriots. They're going to take it. The clock stops.
And they're going to decline the penalty.
Smart decision there. You get the yards. You keep the clock stopped because of the penalty. The Greenies have got to be disciplined switching in and off the field.
Right.
You can't allow free plays like that, especially with short clock here.
Right. And this is it's a late half situation. You know, a lot going on, moving with a lot of tempo. Easy to get kind of lost in the sauce, so it's understandable. Whistles coming in. And I believe a timeout called.
Yeah, last
by the Patriots, and that's the last timeout.
I'm a little surprised by that call. They just let 10 seconds tick off the clock. I think there was a little miscommunication on the field by the coach, Marshall McDuffie, and the quarterback. But they're still going to have a chance here. 34 seconds, no timeouts, but you don't have that far to go to get in field goal range.
Special shout out to our beloved Brian Sheridan, the senior, doing a fantastic job out here. Great, playing some great tunes, DJing for this student section, DJing for the home crowd, and the crowd loving what he's putting down tonight. So special thanks to Brian Sheridan. Kalinga in the shotgun. Crowd getting real loud. Oh, pressure coming late. Gets it away to Anthony Carey. Cooper Perrone making a big tackle.
You got to give credit right now to the Greenie defense. Coach Walker huddled with the guys, and they've made some great adjustments. The linebackers are in there making plays, whereas before they were getting blocked, they're making some great plays now.
They're going to take it, and they're going to spike it with 11 seconds to go. That was a great tackle by Cooper Perrone inbounds. You know, really just trying to fight forward, but Cooper Perrone not giving an inch and makes a great tackle. Again, that's another junior on this team that still has another year left to develop and can become even better. While this is a team that has a lot of really talented seniors, got a lot of really talented juniors and sophomores that are playing very well.
Let's bring it. Come on, well, that was also a good job by Ethan Serrano getting pressure up the middle in front of the center, Caleb Cummings, and defense. One more stop here, and you let the clock run out.
Right. Snap taken. There's Carey's going to get around the edge. And there is Caden Jones. Oh, my goodness. What a hit. Caden Jones.
Well, he's up to seven tackles tonight. He's been everywhere on the field. The Greenie defense really turning things around in the second quarter. They only allowed, I believe, one score. And now they've got a chance. They're getting the ball. They will They will not get the ball to start the second half, but
the Patriots will.
Yeah, the defense making play after play right now, keeping this offense, giving them a chance to turn things around.
Very much so. What a hit by Caden Jones to end the half. And with that, we're going to take a break, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back in 12 to start the third quarter.
Thank you for tuning in to CSBN as always, and we'll see you at the start of the third. just going to put these – we need to put the headsets on, right? Where do you want us to stand? Yeah, they're off. They're off. Check one, two. Yep, we're not on. So where do you want us to stand? Like, okay, so what are we – we're saying
– what are we saying? Yeah, it's a good song. It's a good song.
Don't let me down. Don't let me down.
Okay, I got an idea. I got an idea.
Okay.
This is Henry Square. Oh, hang on. Yeah. This is Henry Square coming live to you from Richard Faso Field. Got a beautiful night for some football. I'm Henry Stewart.
I'm Henry Lytle. Currently, Christ School trailing 23-29. About to start the third quarter. Make sure you tune in on CSBN.
It's going to be.
You can find the link on YouTube. My phone. No, we're good. Let's do the same thing. Same thing.
Welcome to Henry Squared. I'm Henry Stewart.
And I'm Henry Lytle.
We've got a beautiful night here in Arden, North Carolina, coming to you live from Richard Faso Field. Got a great matchup on tap between Christ School and Carrollwood Day.
Currently, Christ School trailing 23-29. We're about to start the third quarter. Make sure you tune in on CSBN. You can search in Christ School Broadcast Network on YouTube to find the second half live.
Let's go, baby!
Dude. I'm gonna get my GoPro working. I'm gonna buy an HDMI adapter for my GoPro so we can run it for CSBN. I'm just gonna go to like Walmart or something, grab that. But yeah, let's do it. Well, I'll just wear this, but you can wear that if you want.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Christ School Broadcast Network. We're here for the start of the second half. The Carrollwood Day Patriots set to receive this kickoff. Matthew Hamill here to kick it off for the Greenies, and it's going to be an action-packed second half if it's anything like it was here in the first, Henry.
Absolutely, no doubt. This is a Greenies team that fought so hard to get back in this game. They have all the momentum in the world, the hometown behind them, ready to do some damage. And Matthew, as you said, Matthew Hamill getting ready to just get set up, but Coach Walker and the team going back to the drawing board, made a great push at the last end of the half. If they can just get a stop on defense, get some points up, and they may have it. They probably might have the lead. Hamill going to go with an onside kick. It's on the turf. The Greenies, they got it. Mulasia picked it up for the Greenies. Christ School has it. What a way to start the second half, coming from behind.
Well, the energy on this sideline is emphatic right now. What a kick from Matthew Hamill. That was a textbook onside kick.
Wow.
Bouncing around, wobbling back and forth. And Louis Saya there to scoop up that ball and give his offense a chance to take the lead.
Absolutely. What a kick. A beautiful onside kick. I am myself getting fired up. I'm going crazy up here in the booth. And Trey Mooney and the Greenies coming out on offense first to start it. What a way to start the second half. We had some fireworks against Latin. We got some fireworks here against the Patriots. Going to drop back. Mooney going to look to throw. He's going to escape the pocket. Mooney tripped up. Solid pickup. He's only going to get a couple.
He was looking downfield. Great coverage from the Patriots. Second and six now for the Greenies. Good job of Mooney again to make something out of good coverage downfield. And Greenies, great field position here. What a way to start the second half.
That is just unbelievable by Matthew Hamill. So good. They were working on onside kicks this week. My goodness, it paid off. And here we go. Trey Mooney in the shotgun. He's going to get it. He's going to throw it quick screen at to Khalil Conley. Gets a block, turns the corner. Khalil Conley knocked out of bounds. First down, Greenies.
Khalil Conley did a good job grabbing the ball, running down the sideline, and he avoided the contact going out of bounds. No need to put himself in danger there. Picks up the first down, and this drive is looking solid.
Very good
start for the Greenies.
Indeed, very good for the Greenies. Just getting fired up here, doing a fantastic job. Getting right back into this ball game. You know, we were talking about maybe the defense is coming to stand. No, how about the offense getting out here and getting after it with a chance to reclaim the lead? Even if they score or miss the extra point, it is still a tie game. Mooney, deep shot. Matthew Pethel with the catch. Pethel taken just shy of the first down. We've got another Greenies first down. It's going to be a first and goal for the Greenies.
Well, that's a great play by Matthew Pethel. He did a good job of finding the space. You know, he's about 6'7 on the field, towering over the rest of the players, a big target, grabbing the ball, running after the catch. Coach Walker loves some of these guys that come over for basketball, big athletic guys that can help him out on the football team, and he's made something special out of Matthew Pethel on the football field.
Absolutely, they're going to keep it. There's Lewisia driving down to going to be taken down just shy of the goal line.
Well, they're bringing back this unit that ran a little read option to Caden Jones earlier. They liked what they saw there. We'll see if it's something similar here, a direct snap and a run to a certain side.
Yeah, Caden Jones obviously taking the snap out of the Wildcat last time out, and he scored for the Greenies. So we're going to have a set there, the same set. Triple stack to the right, Jones and the Wildcat, direct snap. And he's got two touchdown Greenies.
And Caden just Jones, like that. I mean, you can't draw it up any better if you're the Greenies. This read option play is working in the red zone. They have found success tonight in the red zone, coming out with points every time. A touchdown three times and a field goal. That is a big success for the Greenies. Matthew Hamill here has got a chance to kick the extra point.
And just like that, the Greenies have come all the way back. They were down 29-10. They've scored and gone on a serious run. Pethel, they're going to fake it. Ironic. Chucks it. End zone intercepted. and we are going to remain tied at 21. Coach Walker trying to go with some trickery.
Well, I think maybe it was trickery. It was tough to tell. It was a little bit of a wobbly snap, so Iwanek, feeling the pressure, he felt like he needed to try to make a play.
Heck of an effort nonetheless by Iwanek under heavy pressure, flinging it up there. Got intercepted, but no harm, no foul. It's just the extra point. We're going to stay tied at 29 for now. But that is a heck of a possession by the Greenies. No incompletions, no dead lost negative plays. They literally went right down the field and scored. That is the exact way to get back in this ball game. Coach Walker, you know, went to the drawing board and drew up some fantastic plays in the locker room, paying dividends here, and the Greenies are right back in this one. What a night it's been here in Arden. We're just getting the second half started, and that's pretty hard to believe. This is why we love it, folks. The definition of Friday Night Lights.
Well, absolutely. Matthew Hamill to kick off this one. They went with the trickery last time. Carrollwood Day certainly making some adjustments.
Yeah, they're definitely showing more of an onside kick recovery, and they're going to pooch it. Oh, he lost it! He lost it again, and they're able to fall on it. The Greenies very nearly got that back again. I think this place, that would have brought the house down.
The crowd chanting Butterfingers from the Greenie student section. And now the defense is going to be tasked with stopping the Patriots. They stopped them twice tonight before, a turnover and a stand at midfield. Patriots tie game. They're bringing a new quarterback in. That's Alvante Brown.
Maybe
he's a junior. Hasn't gotten a whole lot of playing time, but
let's see what he does
tonight.
Here. Going to hand it off. There's Anthony Carey. Great defense. There is Jordan Edgecombe again. An animal in the backfield.
Yeah, they moved Jordan Edgecombe around. Defensive line, linebacker. That time he was in the middle, and he made a stop.
Been playing very well at practice. The way that he just was playing very well. You know, just the bull rush and just the ferocity that he brings to the defensive line. A force to be reckoned with and a name to keep an eye on for absolute certainty. Making some adjustments. He's out there actually at linebacker now. He's going to keep it. Turn the corner. Oh, he's ripped down.
I think it was Jordan Edgecombe again on that side of the field.
He was right over there again.
It was Jack Scheimer and Jordan Edgecombe. Scheimer fired up as he got that tackle.
The CEO,
on Isaiah Williams.
The CEO of Damage Incorporated laying the pain out here tonight. And that's going to bring up third down for the Patriots. A big time play. Third and seven from their own 40. And the crowd really getting into it now. They're barking. Pressure coming. Parker, incomplete. Caden Jones out in coverage. That is going to be a three and out for the Patriots, and the Greenies going to be getting the ball right back. First punt of the night.
Caden Jones was there on the coverage. He did a good job getting his hand up, preventing C.J. Lewis, the athletic receiver, from making a play. And the defense holds. Khalil Conley back for the punt return. This is the first punt we've seen tonight, as you said, from the Patriots. Not expecting trickery, but, you know, fourth and long. Greenies get the ball back. The momentum, that's two touchdowns unanswered for the Greenies in a row.
Yeah, it's been big. A little bit of some motion, and they're going to get the snap. Nearly blocked. High, wobbly kick, bounces out of bounds. Takes a bit of a Greenie bounce. Bounce kind of forwards. It rolls out of bounds.
Just shy of the 40.
Yeah, so pretty good field position for the Greenies. And out come the offense.
Well, there are some flags.
Oh, maybe a little bit of, some extracurriculars going on between the two teams.
I saw a Patriot player on the ground. It may go against the Greenies here.
And it looks Zach Myers talking to Jack Scheimer. Maybe he just lost his cool or, you know, necessarily. You can't blame him. It's easy to sit back from from the living room or in the stands and say, oh, he shouldn't be doing that. But, you know, you're not there on the field. You're not putting up with that all night. And, you know, you've been dealing with a really aggressive, chippy team all night. And Yeah,
well,
it is a personal foul.
That's the first personal foul of the night, though. The Patriots, I think, have four or five right now, and Shimer, unsportsmanlike conduct. Still, you get the ball just at the just past the 25, and another chance for your offense to take the lead.
Absolutely. Shotgun look for Money. He's going to look to throw. Money under pressure. Money going to take off. He made a man miss. Trey Money trying to turn the corner. Money going to get run out of bounds, but a nice scramble on another broken play. What can't Trey Money do, folks?
Well, he's looking a little wobbly there.
Oh. And we're going to take a break here.
Well, the Greenies, first and 10 now, but Mooney heading to the sideline. It looked a little shaken up there. He's walking off, so he should be okay, but Khalil Conley is going to be the quarterback. He's a lefty. He played quarterback for Asheville High last year.
Hand it off to Lou Ethesia. A lot of shoving between the two. Oh, and some shoving from a Patriot shoving. Will Newman, no flag, but definitely a lot of extracurriculars going on between these two teams. This is getting really chippy. Really hope that this doesn't get too out of hand, as it's been getting increasingly worse between the two sides. But yeah, Khalil Conley, as you said, Henry, the lefty, played quarterback at Asheville High School. So that was actually his original position.
He was by far Asheville High's most dynamic player, and we'll see what he can do. They like running him with motion plays. It's a quarterback handoff.
Going to take him, and he's hit.
Tripped up. There's a lot of chippiness going on. Especially this is Tavoy Fegan, who's been in the face of Will Newman all game, hitting him in the face and pushing him after the play. Trey Mooney going to come back on the field. It's good to see him back out there.
Yeah, he's back out there. In the shotgun. Very quick turnaround. So hopefully he's okay. But third and 9 coming up for the Greenies. Snap from Mooney. Going to take off with it. Oh, he hurdled a defender. Powers his way forward for a solid game, but it's not going to be enough for a first down.
Well, Mooney having a lot of courage there to take that one up the middle.
Yeah, he is playing really gutsy and fearless out here tonight. And out comes the punt team. Seth Schuler. Yes. And there goes Lucia back on the field. That double set to return. So it's going to remain a 29-29 ball game. The Greenies lost a little bit of momentum there. But no harm, no foul. As we wind down, we're about midway through the third quarter. Good snap from Schuler. Gonna get it away. This is a beauty from Seth Schuler. Takes a little bit of a bounce and takes it just outside the 20.
There's some serious contact.
Oh, yeah. There's a fight breaking out between Quentin Cancel and a couple of Patriots. Some Greenies coming over there.
Yeah, it looked like Quentin Cancel got blown to the ground. And it's been Tavoy Fegan who's been all over the Greenies tonight. He knocked him down. He was talking to him. Cancel defending his friend Will Newman on the other side of the ball as well. And we love chippiness, but you got to be careful here. 21-yard line is where the Patriots are going to begin their drive. a little slow on the last one. We'll see what they do differently here.
Yeah, I think you got a new quarterback, kind of what the Greenies had on their last drive. Got to get him kind of broken in, working in. And, there's a jump. It's Ethan Serrano.
Well, every defensive lineman so far has
jumped.
Yeah, he...
That is going to make it first and five from the 26. There's Carey up the middle, trying to turn the corner. Knocked out of bounds. And
makes
that's
a big play
be a
for
first
down.
Down.
First down by Josh Harrison.
And Josh Harrison, the defensive end, currently ranked as a three-star out there making the tackle out of bounds.
Yeah, Harrison is greatly improved from the time here. I don't think he'd actually played football in his life, really, and Coach Walker saw something in him, and now he's a menace coming off the edge for the Greenies.
He is just a force to be reckoned with, big number three. Keep an eye on him. There goes Carey, tripped up and taken down.
Well, Scheimer had a hand on his leg, but Carey fought through it. A nice six-yard gain. It's going to bring up
second and
short.
And in comes. Quentin Cancel comes out. And Vincent Lytle subs in for him. Number 11 at the bottom of your screen. And he comes right back out. Quentin Cancel comes back in.
Yeah, he was yelling at the coaches. He wants this matchup on the bottom of the screen here.
Yeah, he's pretty fired up. Oh, low snap on the deck. He's going to fling a screen. Oh, good. Contact by Ashton Parker.
And Caden Jones there to stop that one for a loss of two.
Big time stop. Again, he's at about 10 tackles right now.
Yeah.
Just having a phenomenal game.
Well, Caden Jones, it looks like all the other Greenies, it takes a couple of them to corral the Patriot players. But when you see Caden Jones, number seven, on your screen, he is almost always there to take down the opposing player just by himself.
Just so good. Third and four coming up big time. There, Jordan Edgecombe bringing some pressure. That's a good – he's hit, and he's not going to – oh, he fought for it. Let's see where they spot it. I think he's short. We're right at the marker. They're going to – where do they spot this?
Well, there was some sort of whistle that was blown on the field before the play was over, and flags are being thrown. I'm not sure what happened. It may have been a holding.
Yeah, I can't see any flags from where I'm standing, but I'll just take your word. Okay, I do see them now. Yeah, there was a whole jumble of players over by the Patriots sideline. They're actually kind of backing up a little bit. It's still third down, so that was probably probably a penalty against.
Well, no. Actually, I think there were no penalties. Some there's a replay. Maybe someone blew a whistle on a sideline and
okay.
It threw off the players. So
yeah, I think
still third down though for the Patriots.
I think the flag was thrown just to kind of whistle the play dead. But it's third and four. And the student section singing happy birthday to maybe getting ahead.
That's happy birthday to Eob Gill, who does Christ School's word of the day. And now it's up to the defense.
Snap taken.
False
whistle
start.
Dead. That's going to be a false start.
Oh, yeah, it looked like a false start on the right side of the line. It'll move the Patriots back a few yards.
And it is indeed against the Patriots. That's going to make it third and nine. So we... costly penalty there that goes it from second and short to second, excuse me, from third and short to third and nine at the 43. Much needed respite for the Greenie defense as they have a chance at a tougher third down here.
Yeah, it's
going
to get
off the field.
It's going to be up to the corners. We'll see. They're all playing press coverage.
Pressure
who's
coming.
Open.
Brown, deep shot, overthrown, almost intercepted by Zach Myers. Just a bit too out in front of him. That's going to bring up fourth down. And the punt team comes on for the second time tonight. And Khalil Conley and Zach Myers both back there to receive the punt, staying out there.
Yeah, Alvante Brown got a little ahead of himself, saw the pressure, saw a break deep. There were two Greenies there to cover that anyway. And Myers a little bit annoyed at himself, but it didn't even look like he had a chance at that ball. So
it was too
it's
far
still
going to
be back. It's still going to be back Greenie ball about where it, you know, Myers was in the first place. So 3:47 here left in the third. After the Greenies' first touchdown, things have slowed down in this game. The pace has slowed down a little bit.
But that doesn't mean that there hasn't been fireworks. There absolutely
Someone moved
nothing.
On the right side of this line. There was no flag called.
Oh, there's going to be a flag. There was a hit on the punter. It's caught. This is, I don't know. This may be coming back. I don't know. It
yeah,
depends
there was
on the yardage.
I don't under, you know, I saw a false start. The side of the line jumped, and they didn't call anything, and then
there was
Jovan Hudson hit the punter.
Yeah, and it is going to be against the Greenies. And it's roughing. That's 15 yards. That'll back this offense up.
Yeah, Coach Walker not happy about that one.
Yeah, that literally gives the defense, or excuse me, the offense a fresh set of downs. That's 15 yards. A costly penalty. Jovan just coming back there to try and block the punt, and he just gets too aggressive and lost track of where he was. And the defense going to stay out there. Got to play disciplined football. You're kind of coming down the stretch here. You know, this is really when your body starts to hurt and, you know, you're tired. But, you know, you got to keep playing, and you got to keep playing disciplined football. Conditioning has been a big mainstay in practice over the week. So let's see how that affects the Greenies coming down the stretch here and
see if that affects
any penalties.
The Greenies, they've got a lot of guys playing both sides of the football. Like you said, conditioning matters here in the third and fourth. And now a new set of downs at about the 43-yard line. Student section trying to get hyped up.
Yeah, trying to. It's going to be another. No, wait a second. The punt, is the punt team on? Or are they running a?
Well, it must have been a.
Yeah, this is going to be a punt. I don't think the defense. He shanked it. High drive over to the student center. Okay, so it turns out that was a running into the punter call. That was only a 5-yard penalty, not a roughing call. Therefore, it made it 4th and 4, so the punt team sit out there. There was just some confusion because the announcer and the call from the officials was roughing, which was 15, but it was only a 5-yard penalty. My apologies, just a bit of a miscommunication there between the field and the press box.
Well, it was very advantageous to the Greenies. They get the ball back, and a little bit of an unlucky break on the ball for the punter now. And now it's up to the Greenies. Ball back on offense. Tie game.
Coming down the stretch here.
It's been more of a defensive slugfest here in the second.
It definitely has.
By this time in the first, I think we already had like 15 points from each team.
Yeah,
so here's Lewisiah.
And he's going to get maybe a couple back to the line of scrimmage. Oh, he is really just not refusing to go down. Lewisiah driving the pile. Oh my gracious, he never even got tackled. What a run. That's a gain of about 4 or 5.
He's got an incredible motor, just fighting through contact. He made 5 yards out of what looked like no gain.
He was stopped in the backfield. The play was not whistled dead. And that's actually going to be a 6-yard carry. What a run. You want to talk about, as you were saying here, you want to talk about a high motor. This guy could probably power the entirety of the country for a couple hours with how fast that motor is spinning.
Well, I'm sure he could, you know, push my car out of the parking spot later tonight when there's a lot of traffic. But.
Oh, absolutely. Shotgun look from Mooney. They're going to give it right back to him. Bouncing off defenders. That's a first down. Lewisiah and Savoy Fegan going back at it with Will Newman. There's just that jaw jacking.
Well, the fans over here saying sweet Lou as he gets the first down. He's got one touchdown today, playing huge minutes at running back. He's been the workhorse tonight for the Greenies.
Absolutely making a huge statement against a very talented Carrollwood defense. And obviously, with Caden Brown out, this is a big-time task for him, and he is handling this the best he possibly could be right now. He's playing phenomenal.
They're bringing in Jackson Cancel.
At running back, the freshman.
Yeah, he's a sophomore.
Sophomore. It's a bit of a misdirection. They faked me out. I thought Cancel had the ball. But no, it was actually Mooney that had it. And he gets up, picks himself up the turf. And whistles coming in, and I think a timeout from the Greenies. And it is a timeout. Coach Walker calls it. Rallying the troops.
I like the timeout call. Give his offensive guys a break. Draw up a good play here on 2nd and long.
Yeah,
keep some time on the clock.
Yeah, I mean, you've got it. just past, you've got it past midfield. You're in plus territory right now. Give your guys a little bit of a break. You know, you're coming down, it's inside of 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Just give them a little bit of a breather. You know, they've been really, like Henry was saying, a lot of guys out here playing both ways. And that's really, you take that for, you just sit, you know, watching the game, you don't really think that's that much of an issue. But no, this is a very physical game. Guys, you know, running full speed on both sides of the ball, you're going to get worn out quick. It's amazing the level of conditioning and the level of, you know, fitness that these guys are in. You know, they are hitting the weight room for about 30 to 45 minutes before every practice. Just phenomenal stamina here from the Greenies with really really minimal cramping. And the Greenies coming back out now. They're going to have it second down at the 48. And Trey Mooney sets up in the shotgun. And we got a change. That's Cooper Perrone in it, running back, number 22. Mooney with the snap. He's going to bail out of trouble. He's going to pump fake. He's going to go, and he's going to run for it. And out of bounds, but a solid pickup on second down for Trey Mooney, doing what he does best.
Well, by solid, you mean getting right back to the line of scrimmage. Thankfully, those Solomon Williams who got in the backfield, third and long, Greenies have got to throw here.
They have to. They've been really trying to rely on the ground game, which is good, getting that established, but you got to get the ball moving through the air, too, on, you know, third and 10. You know, look for Matthew Pethel. You know, he has almost had a touchdown reception, was very close. You know, really big, tall target. Very athletic for a tight end. They don't have him out there right now.
Well, they got to snap the ball. It's going to be delay a game.
They do.
They got it off,
he
though.
He does just get it off. They're going to check it. There's Cooper Perrone on the screen. Puts his head down and picks up a couple. That'll bring up fourth down just shy of the 45-yard line. And well, what do you do here if you're Coach Walker?
I go for it. I keep the offense out there. You got to get something going. You punt it here, you risk a block punt. Even if you punt it, it's just going to be a flip of about 35 yards if you get a great punt. And so I think you take a chance. Fourth and six, fourth and seven, actually. It's going to be a tough play, but I think it's one you got to make if you want to win this game.
I absolutely agree. I think going aggressive here is a good strategy. It's fourth and seven. It's not fourth and short. It's not fourth and long. It's kind of in that fourth and medium kind of sweet spot. What do you draw? What do you look for here?
I'd run some slants with my receivers. They're gonna send some blitzers.
Yeah, Mooney gonna set up. There is a blitzer. Mooney deep shot. Myers caught, touchdown. No. Oh, they're gonna rule it incomplete. He couldn't hang on through the contact with the ground. It was a touchdown. And that's going to bring up an incompletion and me a turnover on downs. Oh, man.
Well, you know, credit to Trey Mooney. Given his receiver a chance, he threw up a great ball. Myers had a shot, couldn't bring it in through the contact. He's going to be beating himself up over that, though. And I promise you, Henry, he will not make another mistake like that tonight.
No, he won't. He is a highly motivated individual that is really committed to this team all in. Really living by the motto that, you know, NC State uses, a school that he's committed to play at, hard, tough, together, HTT, and that is definitely something that embodies the spirit of this defense. We got Cleaner back in there. He's going to run for it. It's a keeper. Oh, my gracious. Josh Harrison. He had barbecue back there, and he didn't invite Josh Harrison. He hurt his feelings, so we went ahead and hurt Jordan Cleaner.
Well, great play by Harrison. He came from almost the opposite side of the line, had to chase him down. There was two more Greenies there to corral him. Greenies finding an answer to the run game, and I think it starts with bringing some different guys in a defensive line, allowing Jordan Edgecombe and Josh Harrison to make plays off the edge.
Absolutely. Josh Harrison is a big guy. We're coming in at around 225. I mean, you're going to feel that in the morning. That's like getting hit by a freight train coming downhill. That's going to take us to the end of the third quarter. Tied up at 29, coming into the final chapter of this one. Don't go anywhere, folks. We still have a lot of football left and have a heck of a game on tap.
We'll be back here at the start of the fourth for the conclusion of what has been an action-packed Christ School versus Carrollwood Day football game.
social media at Greenie Sports for all the updates, scores, and schedules.
I stopped watching the live.
And a kindly reminder, next Friday night, another home game right here at Christ School, and it'll be Military Appreciation Night. The Greenies host Legion Collegiate Academy. Game time, 7 o'clock.
Well, welcome back to Christ School Broadcast Network. Here's the handoff.
And Carey not going to get much. It's a great atmosphere here. And trying to get the troops rallied as we come down the stretch. Got a great ball game in front of us. Final minutes here. 12, just a minute, 11 and a half to go. But a very, very amazing game so far. This is everything you want this game to be. You know, this is a classic comeback. And this is exactly what the Greenies were hoping for. Gonna hand it off. No, he's gonna fake it. Jordan Edgecombe. Oh, he broke free. Whips it downfield. Intercepted. Khalil Conley. Off to the races.
There's no one there to stop him.
Touchdown, Greenies. Khalil Conley. Oh, baby. Going coast to coast.
They're gonna.
Oh, but there's a flag down.
Well, that was what a play by Khalil Conley, but it looks like it's going to be going back a little bit. They're gonna give the Greenies the interception, but I think a block in the back.
Yeah, oh my goodness, what a return by Khalil Conley. But oh no, we've got a... The students are going crazy. Yeah, and a block below the waist called by Christ School. Oh man, it's coming back, but still a great interception. And a Greenie on the turf. We'll step aside.
That would have been... Well, Quentin Cancel walked right up off the field. Looks to be okay. I think he was just cramping a little bit. And now it's Greenie's offensive ball. Khalil Conley, what a play. I mean, grabbing that ball with one hand. He raced down the sideline. Great blocking, but... One low hit, and Greenies still get the ball at the 40, though. A chance, again, to take the lead.
Absolutely. What an interception, though, by Khalil Conley. Put that on SportsCenter. That's one of the best plays you'll see all season, and no better guy to do that than Khalil Conley. Snap taken by Mooney. He's going to keep it. There goes Trey Mooney. Bounced off a hit.
Yeah,
and there's going to be a flag. That's going to be a horse collar or a face mask.
Yeah, I think it was a face mask. But number 42 on the line for the Patriots. He got his hands in there a little bit behind Mooney. So that'll bring it another first down and advancement of the ball.
Trey Mooney is showing some unbelievable toughness out here tonight, folks. Playing with so much heart and so much passion. Taking some hits, but he gets right back up and keeps chugging. You know, putting his body on the line, and he's drawn two flags because of it. Big time coming here. From Trey Mooney, this is exactly what you want on your senior quarterback, stepping up and leading the charge here late, early here in the fourth quarter in a tight ball game just on the edge of the red zone. Mooney in the shotgun. Luisia going to, oh, they're going to fake it. Oh, wow, really shoving him after the play. But he stays on his feet. That's going to be a loss. He's going to get sacked. He doesn't hit the turf, but it does count as a sack. That's going to move the ball back. A little bit.
Good job by the referees blowing that one dead. It's been chippy. No reason to let the players have unnecessary contact.
Absolutely, and while I totally understand just letting the players play it out, it's gotten to a point tonight where it's on every play. You get a guy like Jack Scheimer that is very disciplined, very down to earth, and you get him on an unsportsmanlike conduct because of this taunting and this jaw-jacking back and forth. That's how you know that this is just a bit too far. in the shotgun as Mone's going to roll out of the pocket. Mone got to get rid of it, running out of time, fires a bomb. Khalil Conley incomplete.
He got tackled. There were two defenders on him and neither turned around, but
that'll
it's
going to
be
third and 19.
Prayer
time here for the Greenies. You're not in field goal range. Honestly, you're probably not going to get this first down. Just try and get as many yards as you can. Put this in a good position for Matthew Hamill and just take the field goal, honestly. You just need points at this point. Break the stalemate and just get on top. And we've got a Greenie on the turf. We will step aside for a moment. Back here in Arden, 9:43 to go, 3rd and 19 for the Greenies on the 20. Snap coming, Trey Mone got to get rid of it. He feels the pressure, stays on his feet. Trey Mone spinning down and taken down. Heck of a scramble, not enough for a first down. Going to be taken out at the 30. Be a 46-yard field goal, which is really pushing it for Matthew Hamill. Let's see what they decide to do here.
Well, it seems like they're keeping the offense on the field.
They're going to go for it.
I'm not really sure what you do. You got to take a chance. 46 yards. Matthew Hamill said he's hit over 45 yards in practice, but it's a real gamble, and you don't want to take a chance on special teams tonight.
Right. It's a really tough call. This is really just a no man's land right now. Snap taken by Mooney. He's going to fling it in the backfield. There's see. Oh, Lou. Sweet Lou. Lost the ball. Oh, my goodness. That may be going to the green. That may be going to the Patriots. Let's see where they rule it. And it's Patriots ball.
Well, it's going to be Patriots ball either way. Lou is about 3 yards short of the first down, so Not the worst time to fumble there, but
I guess yeah, just kind of getting it out of the system in a way.
Well, Greenie's defense coming back out.
Yep, a time to, you know, they made some great plays here tonight. Let's see if they can step up and do it again, folks. At the rate this game is going, we may be headed to overtime. What a night for some football! What a game this has been. I said it earlier, but this is why we love high school football, the definition of Friday Night Lights. Get the guys and get your crew together and do some tailgating, eat some good food, and watch some good football. This is what it's all about here, folks. We're going to run a heavy set up the middle. Carey just refusing to get taken down, and he finally gets ripped down.
Yeah, he gained about 4 on that carry.
Here's Jordan Edgecombe and Quentin Cancel.
Yep.
As well as Caden Jones, just a whole swarm of Greenies out there. And they are going to give the credit to Jordan Edgecombe, racking up a huge game here tonight.
Yeah, he's playing great. Jordan Edgecombe making a big difference on that line. You know, a little bit outsized against some of those offensive linemen, but he's got some speed, and he knows where to go to make plays.
Absolutely. He is a demon in the weight room, too. He's a sophomore. The sophomore out of Atlanta, Georgia, really just doing, talking to me last week, riding home on the bus together, sharing a pizza, talking about how he just wants to get some recognition and just get some offers coming in. And I think he's doing more than enough to get those offers rolling in right now. So we got any scouts out there watching this game tonight? Jordan Edgecombe, number 44, take a look at him, because he is going to be a force to be reckoned with here in the coming years. And he's already a menace. He's going to get even better.
Well, that was a great stop by the Greenies line there, and now third and five. They're running a pitch.
Oh, Katie Jones made the hit. Can he get around the corner? Yes, he can, down the sideline. Stays in bounds. Runs over a defender, finally taken down, but a huge play. And
well, Ashton Parker got leveled. I think he stepped out at about the 35.
Yeah, real field flipper there.
Well, you got to give credit to the Patriots. That's a great play call.
Yeah, that is a great play call.
Running the pitch on third and five.
Great execution.
He did a good job to keep his feet in bounds as well, C.J. Lewis. But Caden Jones had a chance in the backfield. You know he's going to be thinking about that one. Didn't quite wrap up against Lewis. And what could have been a big stop for the Greenies turns into a chance to score now for the Patriots. And I think timeout by the Patriots on the field.
Yeah, it's an official timeout here.
They may be discussing the spot of the ball then.
I think so. We've also got a – yeah. Probably just discussing the spot of the ball here, but defense getting some refuel here with some water and some Gatorade, and we're coming back out to do battle here. 7:16 to go, tied up at 29. In all likelihood, if the Patriots score here, that gives you about 5 or 6 minutes left on the clock. This is probably enough for a last drive, and that's when you make your stand and you get your offense out there. You know, obviously you want to go for the stop, but it's almost better to just let them score. That way you have more time. Oh, great tackle! And who is it? None other than Jordan Edgecombe standing over Anthony Carey, saying, this is my house.
Jordan Edgecombe and Ethan Serrano in there to make the play. The two defensive linemen made a great stop. Loss of one, second and long now for the Patriots.
Two unbelievably talented freshmen. Ethan Serrano has also had a great game. Another sophomore out of Dallas, Texas, playing at Parrish High School before coming to Christ School midway through the year last year, and has made a huge immediate impact on this Greenies defensive front. Snap taken. He's going to look to throw. Going to check it out in the flat. Oh, what a great hit initially.
Jacob Iwanek was in there to slow him down, and Caden Jones in there to wrap up for the tackle.
Combined effort, that's going to bring up third and 11.
Yeah, and you saw Jordan Edgecombe get his hands up there. He couldn't affect the quarterback, but made a play to get his hands up and try to block the throw. I think that confused Cognigliò back there.
Absolutely. I think anything you can do to try and, you know, throw a wrench in the defender's psyche is the best. So it's third and 12 from the 29 right now. Student section getting into it. Big play here, coming down the stretch. Snap taken, blitz coming. Deep shot, hits the turf, incomplete. Greenies get the stop on third down. And again, this is bringing up fourth and 12. Again, this is fringe field goal range. Do you trust your kicker, or do you just try and punt it and pin them deep? I think you go for the field goal here.
Well, I think they may punt it.
Well, the kicker,
I don't know,
lining
wow,
up and going through the motions and kicking a field goal, but you know, their kickers, they've got their kicker and their partner playing both positions.
It's gonna be just shy of a 45-yard field goal here.
This is a long field goal attempt. And the student section getting into it. Cowbells everywhere, chanting from the students. It's up and it is wide left. It is. Oh no, it's short. It's short. And no good, and the Greenies get a huge stop. They're going to come out at the 29. Big-time play and from the defense. As the saying goes, defense wins championships, and it might just take the Greenies to a victory here tonight.
Well, he didn't put enough mustard on that one, and now 5:36 from the 20-yard line for the Greenies. This is where men are born. This is where the true athletes distinguish themselves inside of, you know, less than half of what was on the fourth quarter going, and it's been a battle. No, it's scoreless so far in the fourth, but the team that scores is likely going to be the one to take this one home first.
Absolutely, and as you said it, this is when players step up and write themselves into the history books, because future classes will look back and think, this is that time that Christ School upset the Carrollwood Day Patriots and won a huge game. You know, coming into this one, a lot of people writing off the Greenies, saying that they didn't have a chance, that these guys from Florida were just too talented. That's not the case. Christ School has come here and come to play. They have played lights out at the end of the first half, beginning of the second half. Just simply phenomenal. Even if, you know, they can't pull this one off, it is still a heck of an effort from these guys, and you got to commend them for the effort that they've put in and the warrior spirit that they have shown on every single play. Trimoni in the shotgun on 2nd and 7. He's going to drop back and look to throw. Fling it deep. Zach Myers got leveled, but he makes the catch.
What a play for Myers. He redeems himself there. He dropped one earlier in the end zone through contact, and he was fired up about that, looking at his muscles, shaking one, shaking the other. Big time first down, and Greenies have got the ball past the 40.
Staring down Tavoy Thiegen after that one, obviously beating himself up after that drop pass, but in the end zone, but coming back and redeeming himself right there with a big time grab that gets a great gain. There goes Myers in motion to the top of your screen. Oh, what a jump!
That's going to be on the Greenies. I think it was number 72, Luke Anderson, that was moving.
Fans booing that one, claiming that the Patriots jumped offsides. Personally,
no, the refs got it right.
Yeah,
the fans are going to be fans here, but
right.
The Greenies shot themselves in the foot there a little bit. First and 15 now at the 37.
They still got time, and obviously you want to score, but you don't want to score too quickly here. Under 4 minutes to go here, about 3:50 on the clock. First and 10 from the 42. Trimoni on the shotgun, trips at the bottom of your screen to the left. Zach Myers at the top of your screen. He's going to take the snap. Moni going to look to throw. Moni rolling out of the pocket. Moni trying to turn the corner, and he gets out of bounds. There's a flag down.
I think it's going to be a defensive holding.
I think so. There was a lot of contact downfield.
Trayshawn Burney was all over Khalil Conley,
trying to slow him down at all costs because he has been amazing tonight. Borderline unstoppable. Let's see the officials deliberating on the call here. Let's see what they signal.
I believe.
Or maybe there is no flag. Oh, they're going to call it against the Greenies. Oh, I didn't. Coach Walker is fired up over there on the sideline. So is his hometown team. Oh, they do call it against the Patriots.
I think he pointed in the wrong direction.
He just got kind of caught up. Coach Walker was heated down there on the sideline, and I can't blame him. This is a miscommunication with the officials and the fans. Obviously happy with that one, and again, there is that signature chant. You can't
well, it's 10
do
yards
that.
Holding there is 10 yards from the spot of the foul. So that moves the ball past the 50-yard line. Greenies first and 10 from the 54.
Big time opportunity for him here. Moni in the shotgun. Going to take it. He's going to keep it. Mooney's got a hole. Trimoni staying on his feet. Oh, he gets blasted to the turf. But he pops right back up. What a play by Trimoni.
Tavoy Thiegen, who's been chippy all game, making big plays on defense. He got in there, hit Moni high. Moni was a little bit off balance, and he came tumbling to the turf. But another first down for Christ School. It's going to be a gain of 9. So, 2nd and short for the Greenies.
From the 46, that's a heck of a run by Trimoni. He got popped by Tavoy Thiegen, but he just popped right back up off the turf. Got guts of steel, playing with no fear. He's going to keep it again. It's another quarterback draw. Got a convoy, and he's got a first down.
Mooney's making big plays tonight. Great job from him getting the ball past the 30. He fumbled the snap a little bit, just bobbled it. So instead of handing off, he took it himself and used Lou as a blocker. Smart decision, if you ask me. And really, now the Greenies.
Yeah, absolutely. Really shows the ball intelligence that Trimoni has. The fact that he's just able to, you know, recognize that in the moment, make that decision, make the play to stay behind Lou, the blocker, and take a nice gain upfield. Almost 2 minutes to go here. Play clock winding down. They do get the snap off with about a second to go. There's Lou Essia, and he's going to get a solid pickup there as we get closer to 2 minutes now. And now if you're the Greenies, you want to start burning a little bit of clock. You know, you were able to move down the field in some decent time, but you don't want to leave. You really want to leave Carrollwood Day with as little time as humanly possible on the clock.
Absolutely.
Greenies have two timeouts, but the Carrollwood Day still has all three.
And you're almost there in field goal range where you feel confident. It'd be a little far for Hamill now, but I think it'd be just shy of 50-yard lines. You get a few more yards, and you're feeling really good about your chances at a field goal, even
Absolutely.
If you can't convert this first down.
Shotgun look for Mooney. Two to the left, two to the right. There goes Lou in motion. They're going to keep it with Mooney. Bounces outside and just kind of throws himself on the turf.
Yeah, the offensive linemen were confused with the count. No false start or anything. Just a loss of a yard. And it looks like Christ School's going to call a timeout.
Yeah,
so a minute 15 left. You got to get more yards, and it's third and long. This is a tough situation right now for the Christ School.
Honestly, if I'm Coach Walker, I just dial up kind of like a draw, kind of run play. I would give it in the hands of either, you know, Lucia or Trey Mooney. You know, you don't want to take shots through the air. You want to be a little bit conservative here. Obviously, third and 11, that's not a high percentage down. If it's third and short, maybe you go to the air. But, you know, this is kind of deep. They're going to be expecting a pass. For me, I would just kind of keep it on the ground. Just try and get it just into field goal range for Matthew Hamble, because this is a tie game. We are tied at 29. A field goal puts you on top. And there's a minute 15 to go. You know, you run a play here. You kind of let some clock burn down. You know, I would honestly let it burn down to about a second or so and then call a timeout and then, you know, send on the field goal unit. Obviously, this is just me talking. Coach, what he's calling down there, completely different. Just trying to diagnose the situation. But Matthew Hamill down there on the sideline, kind of keeping to himself, just trying to get himself locked in, I think he knows what's getting ready to come.
Well, it's up to Trey Mooney right now in the backfield.
Mooney going to roll out of the pocket. He's going to keep it. Trey Mooney into the open field. Bulldozes a defender.
And he got him right back there. Tavoy Fegan hits the deck after Trey Mooney lowers his shoulder. He made one play, but he couldn't make them all. And that should be enough for a first.